they schedule our appointment so early, and if you guys, like, haven't really watched my channel or anything, I work third shift, so waking up early is like, no. And, so I didn't eat before I went. I tried to wake up early enough so I could eat before I went, but I kept setting the alarm back. But my child was not sitting still, and the nurse just kept making all of these comments and was like, oh my god, like, I can't see anything on her, she's not sitting still, I can't get good enough pictures, blah blah blah. And I'm like, okay, well, you do this for a living, so figure it out. And she was like, did you eat this morning? Did you have any caffeine? And I was like, no, I have only had straight water. I drank some water, that was it. I didn't have any caffeine, and I was also too tired to eat. And she's like, oh, that must be the problem. Yeah, look at her, she just started stomping, like, where's my food? I'm hungry. And I was like, oh my god, do not make me feel bad. I am not starving my baby. Like, I'm going to eat when I get home. Like, y'all know I work third shift. Like, my boyfriend tells everyone, like, we work third shift. Like, if you could schedule the appointment a little later in the day, that would be great. But they don't listen. So, I need to find a different foundation. I used to love this foundation. Or maybe it's me. Because I used to prime my face and everything, and I'm not priming my face. I'm just like, I put whatever. Anyway, so basically, she couldn't get the freaking pictures of my child's heart and her, like, hands and feet. So we had to reschedule the appointment, which I was mad about, because obviously I'm gonna have to pay for it because she can't. Because she just let a little fucking not even born child defeat her. She does this for a living, and you let my fucking unborn child defeat you at your fucking job. So, I had to reschedule the appointment. So, 2 weeks later, we went back, and it was a different nurse this time. And I ate. I didn't have caffeine, so it should have been fine, right? No, this nurse was getting so mad, and she kept, like, with the Doppler on my stomach, like, she'd be like, move over, and I'm like, what the actual fuck? And then she would, like, I guess she could see that I was like, are you out of your fucking mind? And then she would start giggling and then make jokes, and I'm like, I'm not laughing, like, I don't think this shit is funny. Like, you guys are really, like, pissing me off. Like, every time I come in here, y'all have something to say about my child. And I've been really disappointed in the ultrasound, the sonogram pictures that they've been giving me. Like, I guess she just looked at me and she's like, okay, she's fat. She's just fucking overweight. Yeah, she's 6 months pregnant, but she's just fucking overweight. Because she didn't even look down at my fucking weight. But then she finally looked down and she was like, like, she literally even did that. She was like, okay, actually, it looks like you lost 5 pounds since we saw you last. And then she paused and she said, I mean, you still have to eat, okay? And I was like, okay, no shit. If I wasn't eating, I would lose more than 5 fucking pounds. But at the same time, it's like, don't tell me, like, oh, you gained weight, but don't lose the weight. Like, don't, like, what do you guys want from me? So I gain weight, I get scolded. I lose weight, I get scolded. I'm done. Like, don't ever say anything about my freaking weight again. I did my eyebrows very dark. Very dark. That's okay. We're going with it. I do want to do a get ready with me. Shadow. I got a new palette, which I'm gonna show in my the next video I make. I'm doing a haul video, and I hate that dry spot. Like, it just cracks and shit. I hate it. So frustrated by that, but so I literally, like, the glucose test came back good. It came back normal. She said something was low. I have an appointment on next week to do a little checkup, and they're gonna talk to me about it, but as long as the glucose test came back good, I'm good. So yeah, there was also, when I did go in for the 20-week ultrasound, my boyfriend had to run back out to the car because he forgot his face mask, so I just went ahead and went in because it was cold, and I went up to the registration desk, and she asked me what I was there for, and you guys know, like, I don't phrase things right. I should have said, I'm here for my ultrasound, but instead I said, I'm here for my pregnancy, which, I mean, technically, and then she looked down at my stomach, and she's like, are you in labor? Yeah, I'm in labor. I'm just standing here, nonchalant, by myself. Like, my boyfriend went back out to the car just to get a face mask, but she didn't know that. For all she knew, I came in alone. I can't make that shit up. And then today, I called my insurance company so I could get a list of pediatricians that my insurance, pediatricians that will take my insurance. Because you have to have a pediatrician lined up, you know, beforehand. I have to get some vaccine. It's like a DTaP. I don't know what it's technically called, but it's for a whooping cough, so that's important for me to get. I have to get that, and in order to get that, I have to have my pediatrician. But you also have to have a pediatrician before, like, your pediatrician releases your baby from the hospital. And also, I mean, just so I can go ahead and get my maternity leave set up, I have to have my pediatrician fill out a form. So obviously, like, I need to go ahead and get one. I'm due in 12 weeks. I don't know why I forgot that. 12 weeks. 12 weeks. Yeah, and it's already halfway through the week, so almost 11 weeks. Oh my god, it's coming up. That's so crazy. I can't wait to have my little baby here. Like, I'm just so excited to have a little baby. test was a little rough, though. Like, when she took the first vial of blood, I was like, okay, I'm not gonna lie, I'm feeling faint. And then she took a second vial of blood, and I'm like, okay, so I really might pass out. And then... am I putting blush on? I just do.